Hello everyone, welcome back to the session. In today's session, we will be discussing another C++ program to find the largest, smallest, and second largest of three numbers using the concept of simple if statement. Simple if is also called as a one-way branch. Okay, so let us have a look into the C++ program. So first two lines are header file hash include within the angular bracket iostream.h stands for input output stream header file. Okay, second one hash include within the angular bracket conio.h stands for console input output header file. Then comes the void main function. As everyone is aware of this term, void main means a begin of your C++. Every C language and C++ programming language will have a one by default function that is called as a void main function. So if I use the term void means, this main function does not return any value. If I use the term in my program as void one blank space main function means this main function does not return any value. If I use only main function instead of this void, if I use only this main function means this main function should return a value. Got the point? Then comes open flower bracket. That means begin of your C++ program. Here I have declared six variables. They are represented by A, B, C, large, small, and SL. Okay. SL stands for second largest. Among three numbers, I need to determine which is the largest and which is the smallest and which is the second largest. That I need to calculate and I need to display at the end of the program. For that purpose, we wrote a simple C++ program. Okay. So have a look at 5-6 variables, A, B, C, large, small, second large. CLR, SCR stands for what? Clear screen function. Then comes cout stream insertion. Stream insertion is an operator that is exclusively used with the cout statement. Cout stands for console output. Okay. Double quotation starts here. Enter three numbers. Enter three numbers. Backslash n indicates cursor comes to the next line because of backslash n. Okay. This is nothing but escape sequence. Double quotation close. End with semicolon. In the next line, I'm just accepting three values. Okay, cin stream extraction A, stream extraction B, stream extraction C. This way of style is writing is called as a cascading of input by using only one single input statement, by using of multiple stream extraction to accept more than one value. I'm accepting how many values? Three values. Okay, variables are A, B, C. Got the point? This way of style is writing is called as a cascading of a input. Got the point? Next, large equals to A. Large is a variable that is assigned to A. So before this, I need to input three values. Okay. I need to input three values. Say, for example, 10, 8, and 5. 10 is stored in A, 8 is stored in B, and 15 is stored in C. Do remember the values. 10 is stored in A, 8 is stored in B, 15 is stored in a C. Okay. So next, large is equals to A. What is the value of A? 10. 10 is assigned to which variable? Large. Now, large equal to how much? 10. Let us assume that. I'm just assuming that the first element itself is the largest. Still, I need to compare with the second variable, second and third, B and C. Okay. So simply first, we are assuming that large equal to A. The value of A is 10. 10 is assigned to which variable? Large. Next comes the condition. If, open parenthesis, B is greater than large. What is the value of B? 8. 8 is greater than large. What is the value of large? 10. 8 is greater than 10. 8 is greater than 10. Condition false. Condition false means I won't execute this large equal to B. This large equal to B will execute only when the condition is true. My condition is false. 8 is greater than 10, condition false. Then I have to go for the one more condition. Again, to check with the third value. If C is greater than large, what is the value of C? 15. And what is the value of large? 10. 15 is greater than 10. 15 is greater than 10. Yes, it is true. 15 is greater than 10. Yes, it is true. True means large equal to what? C. What is the value of C? 15. 15 is assigned to which variable? Large. Look at this. Large equal to 15. Do remember the value. Large equal to 15. Okay. Then now, next. Now, to compute which is the smallest among three numbers. These five lines are for to compute the largest among three numbers. And these five lines are for to compute which is the smallest number. Got the point? That is why we have just made a change in color. Small is equals to A. Let us assume that the first number itself is the smallest. Let us assume that the first number itself is the smallest. Okay. So what is the value of A? 10. 10 is assigned to small. Okay. Small is equals to A. The value of A is 10. 10 is assigned to small. Do remember, small is equals to 10. I need to compare with B and as well as C. Okay. If B is less than small, what is the value of B? 8. 8 is less than 10. 8 is less than 10. Yes, it is true. 8 is less than 10. Yes, it is true. True means I need to execute small equal to B because my condition is true. When this condition is true, means I need to execute this. Small is equals to B. What is the value of B? 8. 8 is assigned to small. Okay, 8 is assigned to small. That is what we have assigned here. Small is equals to 8 and large equal to 15. Still, I need to compare the third variable. Okay, if C is less than small, what is the value of C? 15. The value of C is 15. 15 is less than small. What is the value of small? 8. 15 is less than 8. Condition false. Condition false means I won't execute this statement. This statement will be executed only when the condition is true. But my condition is false. 15 is less than 8, condition false. So I won't execute this. Directly, I'll go with the next one. SL indicate second largest. In shortcut, we took it as a SL. SL is equals to A plus B plus C, close bracket, minus, into bracket, large plus small, close bracket. So I need to substitute the value of A, B, C, and large as well as small. So what is the value of A? The value of A is 10, and the value of B is 8, and the value of C is 15. Okay. So 15 plus 8 is 15 plus 8 is 23. 23 plus 10 is 33, right? 15 plus 8 is 23. 23 plus 10 is 33. Okay. So this becomes 33 minus large plus small. What is the value of large? Large is 15. Small is 8. 15 plus 8 is 23. 33 minus 23. 33 minus 23 will be 10. 10 is assigned to which variable? Second large. 10 is assigned to which variable? Second large. Among three number, which is the largest number? 15. Which is the smallest number? 8. Which is the second largest? 10 is the second largest. That is what it assigned to which variable? SL. SL stands for second large. Now I need to print with the help of an output statement one by one. First, I need to print large. Then I need to print small. Then I need to print a SL. See out the first one, stream insertion within the double quotation, largest number is equal to, will print as it is because that is written under double quotation. Okay, that is a string. Group of characters enclosed between the double quotation, that is called as a string. Okay, the same thing is going to display on the output device, that is on monitor. Okay, stream in double quotation closes, stream insertion large. What is the value of large? 15. 15 is going to be printed in the same line, and cursor comes to the next line because of endl. Again, one more output statement, C out, stream insertion, smallest number is equal to, will print as it is. Okay. So again, double quotation close, stream insertion in place of small, I am going to print as the value of small as 8. Large was 15, small is 8. Okay. Again, cursor comes to the next line because of endl. One more C out statement, C out, stream insertion, double quotation start, second largest is equal to, will print as it is on the output device. Okay. Because that is written under double quotes. Double quotation closes, stream insertion, SL. What is the value of SL? 8. 8 will be printed here. In place of large, it is 15. In place of small, it is 8. In place of second large, 10. In place of second large, it will be 10. Okay, stream insertion, endl. Cursor comes to the next line. And at the end, get function and this close flower brackets. Okay. Why do we use get function? Once we compile the program and we'll run the program, we'll input the values. once we press the enter button, we'll get the output there itself without coming back to the programming screen. For that purpose, we used to write getch function followed. And this close flower bracket indicates end of C++ program followed. This is what the program to find the largest, smallest, and the second largest among three numbers. This is what the analysis part. You can go through this. Okay, it will be easily understandable. Fine. Thank you. Thank you for watching this video.